Good day, students. You're welcome to another edition of Scholars Universal's online teaching series. This is Business Studies. In our Business Studies class, we'll be taking the topic Petty Cash Book. Okay, so at the end of this class, you're expected to be able to divine Petty Cash Book, divine an explain impress system. You should be able to define cash flows. You should be able to align the advantages of an impress system. You should be able to list the procedures of preparing an impress system, and also to be able to prepare the Petty Cash Book. Okay, now when we talk about Petty Cash Book, impress system, and the like that, first of all, I want us to consider the concept impress system. Now, what is impress system? Usually, when you know we have different type of organizations, but most especially let's talk about the so-called big organizations. Now, when we have the major accountants, and you know when you have an accountant in a big organizations, because it is a big organization, you will agree with me that the number of money that the accountants will be dealing with and recording will be, you know, much in terms of the millions. Times it could be billions, it depends on how big the organization is, and the nature of work that the accountants will be doing will be much. Now, the question now is, of course, you know that despite the fact that the accountants will be dealing with millions and the likes like that, the question is, are you telling me now that the organizations will not incur small expenses like, okay, take for instance, expenses worth 100 naira, take for instance, like the HOD or someone wants to recharge, and then the cost of recharging is 100 naira or 200 naira or 500 naira. Of course they can. Now, at the point when they are, you know, incurring expenses that are not too expensive in terms of, okay, 500 naira, 1000 naira, now, how do you expect them to treat that? Are you saying that the accountant that deals with millions, that deals with too many work, will still be the person to come and be posting transactions of 100 naira, 200 naira, and say 1000 naira? Or are you telling me now that they will not post such transactions? So, of course, in accounting, you are supposed to, bookkeeping and accounting, you're supposed to, you know, post all transactions or everything that happens in the business. So to be able to post such transaction, now that is why there is a need for impressed system. So now when we talk about impressed system, what exactly is impressed system? So impressed system is the system of recording petty cash transactions which are paid out of cash flows. Now when we talk about petty cash transactions, from the word petty is small, you know, small minor expense. So we are talking about all those small expense that arises in the business. Someone wants to deliver goods from my company or for my company, and the person needs maybe 200 naira to take to transport himself from the company to where the person is going, 200 naira, or I need to get a postage stamp of maybe 50 naira. So how do they, or how should we account for such money or for such transactions? So usually what we need is, you know, to have a working impress system. So the impress system, we have said, is the system of recording small transactions which are paid out of cash flows. So what big organization does in most cases, so that they will not be giving or they will not be killing their accountants with too many work, is that they will have an impress system. So what they will do is, for each maybe unit, it could be units, it could be, it depends on how big the organization is. Maybe take for instance, in our school now, you know, of course, you know, we have different departments. We have the you know, administrative department, we have the teaching department, okay, and for each department we have different, you know, subunits. Take for instance, in science, art and commercial, we have different departments, and we have head of the department. Now we could Okay, come to think of, okay, for each department, we could be giving them at the end of at the beginning of every month, we would give them some amount of money, maybe 10,000 naira. Now, that 10,000 naira now is what we call floats. And what would happen to that 10,000 naira is that now, whenever small expenses arise during the month, instead of coming to meet the accountant or the main accountant that you want to use, I mean you need money for something, for some small expenses, you should not. Rather, you would go and meet, the petty cashier or the person that has been given the 10,000 naira, and you to collect money to be able to meet up with those small and minor expense. So what we are saying is that 10,000 naira is the cash flow. So for that month, what will happen is, if any small expenses happen in our within the department, what would happen is the person that needs the money would explain to the petty cashier, "Oh, petty cashier, I need 100 naira. I want to use it to get airtime to be able to call so 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 and so." So what the petty cashier would do is, he would give them petty cash voucher. They will fill it, telling or explain whatever they want to use the money for. Then they will take it to a higher officer, maybe the director or the whatever. They will have told them that in case they want to collect money, they should be getting approval from someone. So they will go to the person that would give them approval, and once the person sign or endorse that thing, the petty cashier will release the money. So what we are saying in essence is, in IMPRES system, it is a system for recording petty cash transactions which are paid out of that cash flow, which is 10,000 as in the case that I have explained before. And I've said that cash flow is the specified amount of money given to a petty cashier to cover for petty expenses during a period. It is usually given at the beginning of the period, and float is fixed. Now, at the beginning of every month, that means they will be giving the petty cashier that specific amount of money. It could be 10,000, it could be 5, it depends on the organization, it depends on their policy. And this is the maximum amount of cash that can be held at any time. And so what we are saying in essence is, the petty cashier cannot hold more than that amount of money. If it is 10,000 naira according to the policy, the petty cashier cannot hold more than that 10,000 naira. So don't forget, I've said that IMPRES system is a system of recording petty cash transactions which are paid out of cash flows. And we have said that the cash flow is the money given to the cashier at the beginning of the period to cover for petty expenses during that period. And also we said float is fixed, that is, and it is the maximum amount of cash that can be held at any time. All right. Now let me talk about, what are the advantages of IMPRES system. Don't forget, the first thing we have said is so that the load of the work, the load of work would be reduced. The load of work for the, main cashier or main accountant will be reduced. So the first advantage of IMPRES system is the burden of the main cashier will be reduced, because the main cashier will not be able to, I mean, would not be the one to be able to account for all the expenses in the business. So all those small expenses will be transferred to the petty cashier. So the main cashier will not be the one to account for everything. You understand? So the first thing is the burden of the main cashier will be reduced, and also it helps to reduce fraud. Because if let's assume the burden of the main cashier has been reduced, or the person the burden is has not been reduced. If the main cashier is the one to account for all the millions and even all the kobos, and is the one that you expect to be checking, because of course for those small expense they should be received. If you are asking the main cashier to be checking all those receipts to confirm that truly they have incurred those expense, of course you know that the work could be too much and the person might not be doing it, very well. So in that case, there could be fraud, because when people notice that even this money or the receipts, the money they are giving us, they are not checking whether we have used it. Of course, there could be fraud. So that is one of the advantages. It helps to reduce fraud. And also, it ensures accountability for every expenditure. That is, they'll be able to check every expenditure would be having accounts. Every expenditure will be documented. Even no matter how small, they will be documented. All right, so let's move to the next part, which is the petty cash book itself. Now, when we talk about, we have known that the imprint system is a system for keeping, you know, petty cash transactions. Now, those petty cash transactions, which book do we record them? We record them in the petty cash book. Now, petty cash book is used for recording small disbursement or expense. Now, examples of those small disbursement are the, you know, or small expense are postage and stamps. Now, okay, you want to send letter from this state to another cell, from this country to another country, you need a postage stamp. So before you can, and those postage stamps, I mean, they're just 50 naira, or you want to transport yourself from, you know, from this, maybe this city to another city, you need, I mean, some a small amount of money to do that. So those are the kind of expenses that are covered under petty cash book. We have stationery, we have carriage, and the like that. All right, so petty cash book is part of the double entry system, and also petty cash voucher shows the reason for the payment and the signature of the person receiving the money. Before you can receive money from a petty cashier, you must have filled what we call the petty cash voucher, and the petty cash voucher shows the reason for the payment. That is, you would have written there, okay, the reason I'm collecting this one is to be able to do this and this. Then take it to an authorizing officer, that is someone that will give you approval, and the person would sign. So the person have to sign before you'll be able to receive any money from the petty cashier. And this is a typical example of a petty cash voucher. As you can see, the date, the voucher number, then the description, that is what you are using the money for. Okay, funds issued for, okay, office supplies, one issue for, okay, maybe transport, one issue for postage, how much? 50 naira. Then whatever you have used the money for, if you have change, you drop it there. Okay, I've collected a change of 14 naira 52 kobo. So definitely the amount of money you, okay, this change will be, you know, dropped there maybe after you have used the money. But before you collect the money, you have to get an approving officer. Okay, it is the manager that has approved. The manager has to sign. You that you receive the money, you have to sign. So this is a typical example of a petty cash voucher. And by the time you are returning this thing, you have to return this thing with a source document. You have to return this thing with a particular, take for instance, you have gone to, okay, this is funds issued for, okay, airtime. And the airtime you bought is, you know, all those card airtime, like you bought card to load the pin on the card. Usually, by the time you are returning this thing, you have to return this thing with that card, the paper you have used that you have used the money to get the paper. After you have loaded the pin, you must attach the paper, the receipt. You understand? So you have to attach the receipt to this petty cash voucher before you submit to the petty cashier. All right. So what are the procedures of, you know, opening petty cash book? Now, the first thing you have to take note is at the receipt, because don't forget that money is being paid out of a float in petty cash system. So the first thing you have to do is when at the point where you received money, you know, which is float from the main cash book, the first thing you have to know is, you know, when you receive, don't forget last week when we discussed ledger entries, when you receive, you debit the receiver, right, and you credit the giver. So this time around, the petty cashier is receiving the money. So what would you do to the petty cashier's account? So you debit the petty cashier, which is the petty cash book. Then the money is coming from who? From the main cashier, which is the main cash book. So you credit the main cash book. So you debit petty cash book, you credit main cash book. Debit petty cash book, credit main cash book. Debit petty cash book, credit main cash book. Because cash book is given out to petty cash book. The cashier is given out to the petty cashier. You understand? All right. So the next thing is you have to rule your petty cash book. You rule it. Now, at the point when you are ruling your petty cash book, now you have to take note that the credit side is wider than the debit side. So the credit side is wider than the debit side. Why? Because what a petty cashier is doing majorly is to be able to be given money to cover for petty expenses. And a petty cashier is not supposed or is not expected to be receiving money. So what the only time the petty cashier could receive money is whenever he's collecting money from the main cashier. So in that case, the only reason why you can have a debit entry is when you collect floats. So aside from that, you'll be paying out money. So in that case, your debit, your credit side is wider, while your debit side is not as wide as the credit side. Because on the credit side, there's a need for analysis. There's a need for analysis. So now, and the debit side, don't forget, we said the debit side is usually the receipt side, that is the receiving side, and the credit side is the analysis column, which is the giving side. All right. So the next thing, which is procedure 3, now is whenever you pay for any expense. Okay, someone had come, they had filled the petty cash voucher, you have seen that the manager has signed, then he wants to issue money. Now, at the point when you are issuing money, what would you do? You credit the petty cash book with payment under the related expenses. Now you credit. Take for instance, the person is collecting money for sundry or transportation. The person has collected, you know, 250 for sundry. What you do is put the sundry in credit side. Then there is an analysis for sundry again. Put it under sundry. Now the reason why we are doing this analysis is because at the end of the month, if they collect money for sundry like 3 times, you should put all those 3 expense under sundry so that I'll be able to see the whole or the entire money that they have spent on sundry for that month. So that is the reason why we are putting it under the analysis column. Please, you have to take note of this because of our test at the end of this class. All right. So the next is total of analysis column. What you need to do is analysis column, I'll transfer to the debit side of the ledger. Because they are transferred to the debit side of the ledger, that is what you will do. Then the next is reimbursement of petty cash book. Now reimbursement is paying, you know, I mean paying back reimbursement. That is what you need to do is at the end of, don't forget that the companies or maybe our company policy is that at the beginning of the month, you'll be collecting 10 as a petty cashier, you'll be collecting 10,000 naira to be able to cover for minor expense. And for instance, for the month of May, we have incurred expense worth 8,000 naira. So usually what will happen is at the end of the month, now when the petty cashier will also take all of those expenses, all the petty cash voucher and the receipt that he has collected, that he has gathered to give out 8,000 naira, he will take everything to the main cashier. Now what the main cashier will now do now is to check, you know, because the main cashier would check everything and see and confirm if it's fine. So as soon as the main cashier confirm it's fine, what the main cashier would do is to reimburse. Now when we say reimburse, the main cashier, because don't forget that the petty cashier has, you know, incurred expense worth 8,000 naira. So what the main cashier would do is to return that 8,000 naira back to the petty cashier. So by the time the petty cashier returned the money, you know, before he has spent, out of 10,000 naira, the petty cashier had spent 8,000 naira. So remaining 2,000 naira. So at the point when the petty cashier is getting the refund, getting a reimbursement of 8,000 naira, so the money with the petty cashier would now, you know, amount to 10,000 naira again. So in that case, what it means is that at the beginning of every month, the petty cashier would have with them the fixed amount of money. That is why we said it is float is a fixed amount of money, and it is the maximum amount of money that the petty cashier could have at every point in time. So the reimbursement, now when the petty cashier is reimbursed, that is collect money from the main cashier, what you would do is you debit the petty cashier, then you credit the main cashier again, just like the way we've done in the first illustration and or the first procedure. So the petty cashier will be reimbursed at intervals to bring the amount back to the formal amount. That is what we are saying. Okay, so Let's consider the format of a petty cash book. So usually, you know, we have the debit side on our left and we have our credit side on our right. Then you have this amount, you have this column amount, you have the column for folio, you have the column for dates, you have the column for particulars. Amount would show the, you know, what of that transaction, the monetary value. The folio is a reference column. Don't forget, we have explained this on our ledgers too. The dates will show the dates that the transaction occurred, and the particulars will describe, you know, the account. And we have our total, which will show the amount, the what. Now this is my analysis column. Now for each of these, okay, expense that has happened. Take for instance, the first transaction here is, okay, we said this is this amount. Any amount seen on the debit side definitely would be the money getting from the main cashier. So this money, okay, now look at this folio. It's telling us that this money is coming from the cash book on the 1st of January, and the money is termed float, because the float is the money used to cover or collected by the petty cashier to cover smaller expense. Now on the 2nd of January, the petty cashier paid for sundry expense. He has paid, take for instance, 60 naira. Now the 60 naira that he has paid will also be posted here. The same amount of money that you have posted in our total is what we will post under the sundry expense. Now take to move further, the next thing is your motor expense. Okay, January 4, the paid for motor expense, take for instance, they have paid 70 naira. The 70 naira would come under motor expense. Now this analysis, usually at times in the question they will give you the analysis to the analysis column that you need to prepare. They will tell you prepare analysis for sundry, motor expense, postage, stationery, transportation, the ledger. At times they would ask you, or they would tell you what to prepare. At times you might not be given what to prepare. So in that case, when you're not given what to prepare, what you need to do is quickly go and glance through the questions and see the set of expenses that the company has. So when you, as soon as you get there, so you need to come and prepare your on your own. Prepare, okay, in this question I have sundry expense, I have to give sundry expense, I have motor expense, I have to give motor expense, I have postage, then I need to get postage, I have stationery, I need to get stationery, I have transportation, and this transportation. Now this is Ademide, like this is the name of a person. Maybe Ademide is one of the person that works in the organization. Now for, you know, money that is approved to a small expense that is approved to give, you know, individuals or persons in the organization, what you are supposed to do is, instead of writing Ademide, you write a ledger, because Ademide is an individual, so you need to post it into the individual's account. So you open a ledger and post such transaction in the ledger. So you open a ledger column. So at the end of the day, by the time you add up all of these transactions, whatever you're giving, let's assume when you added up all of these transactions, we had 600 naira, you write the 600 here. Now for all the sundry expense, let's assume we have another sundry expense. Please, there's no need to open another sundry column. You have to post it under the sundry. Now let's assume you've added all the sundry in the period. You have 200, you post it 200. You added all motor expense, whatever you get, you post it here. All more postage, you post it here. All stationery, you post it. Transportation, you post. Ledgers, then you post. Now you can cancel or close this balance, close all of this as soon as you get the figures, close to this point. Now this total, you are not closing this total yet. Now let's assume this is 600. Now usually what you would do is, okay, there are two things that you could do, you know, or you could decide to go and, you know, reimburse the cash at the end of the month or at the beginning of the next month. Or basically what we need is by the beginning of next month, I want to see the old money back. So let's assume this cash flow is 1,000 naira and you have spent 600 naira. So definitely you have 400 naira left with you. So by the end of the month, I want to be, or by the beginning of the next month, which is February, I want to be seeing that 1,000 naira back. So what you need to do is go to the main cashier and retire the money. When you retire is when you retire, we are saying that you are giving them account of the money you have spent. So you give them all of these transactions with the credit card voucher and their receipt. Then you collect another money, which is 600 naira that you have spent. So in this case, you have 1,000 naira before, you have spent 600 naira, you give them the 600 naira, then they will give you back your money, which is 600 naira. So at the point when you give it 600 naira, at the point when you're giving 600 naira, so the balance that you would have with you, with that 400 naira that you have, now you've collected 600 naira, at that, the end of the period, the balance you have with you will now be 1,000. Because 600 with the 400 that you have with you will be, would come back to 1,000. So by the time you have 1,000 plus 600 there, you get 1,600. Then you know you have 1,000 there, you have 600 there, you get 1,600. So it is the 1,000 naira now, which is the balance carried on, that you will take as your balance brought down in the next one, which is 1st of February. Let's assume this is the next one. You take it here 1st of February, that will be balance brought down. Then all the expense for the period, you start again, you start again, you start again, then to the end of the period, just the way we have done this thing again. All right. So if you understand this so well, let's move to the next, which is the illustration. Let's consider one illustration. And we are asked to record the following in the petty cash book of all out ventures for the month of June 2014. Now, the first transaction is cash float, which is 1,000 naira on June 1st. What you're supposed to do is you debit this cash float of 1,000 naira. You debit it, debit cash float of 1,000 naira. You debit it, then, because it's an inflow to the petty cashier. Yeah? The second is paid for petrol. So definitely, you have to, okay, in these questions, you're not even giving the analysis that you should prepare. But in this case, you know that you are paying, you're incurring money for petrol. So yeah, after putting this in total, you have to create another column for petrol. So the next is paid for stationery. After putting this in total too, you have to create another column for stationery too. So you need petrol, stationery, that's two. The next is postage stamp. After putting this in total, you have to create another column for postage stamp, that's three. Then paid for petrol again, 35. So instead of creating, after putting this in, you know, total, you don't have to create another petrol column, because of course you have a ready-made petrol column, so you have to put this one under the ready-made. So now for the petrol, you now have 135 now. So you have to continue and pay for carriages, carriage, which is 25. So you have to create another column for carriage, which is 25. So let's see how our petty cash looks like. For our solution, the first thing you have to take note is the name of the business and the account you are preparing, All Out Ventures, and you are preparing the petty cash book for the month of June 2014. Okay, so you have to, okay, draw your table. Now drawing your table, you have, okay, don't forget, we have said we have amount, date, particulars, then total, then we have motor expense, you have stationery, you have postage and carriage. Yeah, those are the four columns that we need. Don't forget, this column is, you know, this column depends on the transactions that we want to post. This column depends on the transaction we want to post, depending on the questions that you have been given. And there are some questions that they will give you the analysis that you need to show. All right. So for this June 1st, you received 1,000 naira cash flows. So you have to debit it, then cash flows. All right. So on 2nd of June, they said you pay for petrol 100 naira. Now petrol expense, now you agree with me that petrol is an example of motor expense. So this 100 naira, you're posting it under motor expense, because you are using petrol basically for motor expense. All right. So the next thing is 3rd of June, you incurred money for stationery. This 15 naira under total, then you take this 15 naira under stationery too. 4th of June, postage stamp 15 naira, you take it to postage to 15 naira. Then another petrol, so petrol of 35 naira, then you take this petrol under motor expense again. All right, so the next is carriage. June 8th, carriage of 25 naira, you take this one under carriage. So now this is the end of our transaction. However, you're not stopping here. You have to give us a total of every expense that you have that you have incurred. So you have to give me the total, sum up all of these, sum up all of this, sum up all of this, sum of this, sum of this. All right, so summing up all of this, we have 260. Adding up all of these, we have 135, we have 50, 50, then 25. Okay, so you have to close all of this account, but don't close this account yet. Alright, so this 260, as a petty cashier, you're supposed to go to the main cashier to retire the money and be reimbursed. Now, at the point when you are being reimbursed, the petty cashier will be collecting back the 260 as the end of the month. So when the petty casher recovers the money, he gets back the money that has been spent for the period, which is 260. So he gets back the 260 naira from the main cashier, which is the end of the period for June 30. He received cash, which is 260. And by the time the person received the 260 cash, the ordinarily the after 260 has been spent from 1,000 naira, the petty casher will be left with 740. Now, when the petty casher is receiving 260 back, the money gets back to 1,000 naira. So that's your balance carried down for the end of the period. So the money with the main the petty casher will now return back to 1,000 naira. So we can close our account. That is 260 plus 1,000 will give us 1,260. 1,000 plus 60 will give us 1,260. Now, for the next month, which is July 1st, of course, this is your balance carried down, which is 1,000 naira, is what you'll be taking forward, is what you'll be taking to 1st of July, which is 1,000 naira. Now, you can start take this money back here. Then you start the expenses for the month for July, just underneath or just, you know, beneath. Take, for instance, there for July. So this is exactly how to prepare, you know, a petty cash book. All right. So I'll be giving us questions to work on, to be able to, you know, practice and then ensure we understand this particular topic so well. And also I'll be you have questions that you would be attending at the end of the week to be able to certify that you really understand this. And if you do not have above 70% or 75%, I'm sorry, you might have to take this particular subject again. You don't have to take it again. So you expect to take some practice questions to ensure or to certify that you know understand the topic so well. And the questions are: define the petty cash book, explain the term cash flows, mention advantages of impress system, explain impress system. I mean, and you are supposed to rule a suitable petty cash book with analysis. Now this question is telling you to rule the cash book with analysis, column 4. Okay, they have specified postage and fax, then stationery, traveling expenses, carriage and sundry, office expenses. And also you are supposed to enter the following transactions. Okay, this transaction, according to this, is continuation of question 5, and that is transaction in those the petty cash book template that you've prepared on question 5, because this is a continuation of question 5. All right, so practice enough questions. You could lay hands on your textbooks to practice more questions on petty cash book. And then if you have questions, you can always also ask us on our WhatsApp platform. If you want to be added on the WhatsApp platform, you could also, you know, check the number below this video. Please, I would also encourage that you should subscribe to this channel, turn on your notifications so that you'll be getting more videos that relate to this subject matter. And also please like our video if you've gotten one or two informations that would be of benefit to you. Thank you. Ensure